Welcome to comparison number two between the Flare Pro 2 and the Cafe Let Robot. Last time I compared the features between these two machines. Today I want to compare the workflow and which one produces a better shot. Today I'm going to decide on which one of these machines I'm going to bring to the office with me and use there. I have a semi-auto here at home, so I have no need to do manual espresso, and I'm looking at upgrading here soon. So I'm deciding which one I'm going to use more and which one's just going to go in the closet. So first off, I just want to thank you for joining us here on Kabeen's Coffee Corner. This channel, I do a lot of comparison and reviews to help you choose the coffee gear you want to brew with at home. So I would love your support on my YouTube channel by simply going down and clicking the subscribe button and liking this video, as well as if you're looking at purchasing any gear, please use the affiliate links in the description below where I'll make a slight commission at no extra charge for you. You can also follow me on Instagram at Kabeen's Coffee Corner and see a lot of photos and what I'm doing. And I would love to hear your responses on what questions you have on these machines. What did I miss in this video? So thank you for watching. Over the past month, I've been comparing these regularly side by side, brewing shots, and kind of trying to figure out which one I prefer better on all ends of things between shot, between workflow, and things like that. And I want to answer a few of these questions, but first I want to tell you kind of how I did this comparison. So I used both of these machines with the same grinder, a Kinyu M47 hand grinder. And I put a smart espresso profiler on them. A smart espresso profiler, you can find a few other videos that I've done on that thing. And basically what it is, it's a Bluetooth device that connects to the Flare and to the robot, as well as to a smart scale like the Akaya Cinco or Pixis or Lunar. And this allows me to brew the exact same shot from machine to machine. So it tracks my flow rate and my pressure, so I can brew an identical shot from the Flare onto the robot and compare side by side which one tastes better and know exactly that all of my variables are the exact same, even though the grind side has to be tweaked a little bit just because this is a smaller brew head than what is on the robot. First off, I want to address the workflow. The workflow in my opinion, is better on the robot, as you saw in the head-to-head just before this. The robot was just a little bit easier to clean up. It was less moving parts. And most importantly, the preheat function of the robot is way, way easier than the Flare. I took temperature readings of the robot, of the Flare, and my semi-auto, both doing different preheating methods. For the Flare, I just simply put it on the kettle, just this brew head right here. And for the robot, I put this on the kettle. I also did them without any preheat methods. And by far, every single time, the temperature came out the best on the semi-auto, but then it was followed by the robot and followed by the Flare. In fact, I was able to get a higher temperature of output in the cup from the robot than I was from the Flare, and that was without preheating the robot and preheating the Flare. They run about a 15 to 20 degree difference between the Flare to the robot, and then another 10 degrees from the robot to the semi-auto machine. So for heat retention, the best way to pull the hottest shot possible, which is what you want for espresso, well, in theory, with these, there's a lot of heat loss simply from all of the cold metal that the hot liquid is touching. So for the preheat and for the highest temperature rating, the robot wins on that. As for the workflow of the machine, I think the robot is a little bit easier. There's a little less pieces, little easier workflow. I do like tamping and putting the grounds into the portafilter on the Flare versus the robot seems just kind of a little finicky to me. But overall, I think the robot wins on that. And I want to keep in mind here that this is $309 and this is $450. So when you're comparing these in shot quality, this one is $150 more than this. As I brewed both of these machines constantly over the past few months, having back-to-back espressos, brewing one morning and one a different morning, and then side-by-side, back-to-back, I found that both of these produced phenomenal shots of espresso. I wasn't disappointed in either one of these. And as somebody who drinks a lot of espresso, that's saying a lot. I'm not obviously a barista. I've never done that role. I haven't had as many shots. I don't have as good of a palate as somebody who works in the specialty coffee industry. But for the average home brewer, I would say my palate's just slightly better for the fact that I have been brewing a lot of coffee at home over the past 4 years of specialty coffees all around the US. So I have refined my palate quite a bit and it's still growing and I still have a long ways to go. But for the average person looking for this machine, I feel like I have a pretty good idea of which one will taste better on that. Now that being said, I'm gonna give the taste just by a hair, just by a little bit, is gonna taste better on the Cafe Let robot. I think it's just easier to use. I think it's easier to get that good quality espresso from. I think the Flare is phenomenal. And I think that here's the hard thing. I'm not sure if that difference in taste is worth $150. That's how close it is. I'm not sure if it's worth paying an additional $150 to get the robot, to get that little bit of taste. Especially if you already have a Flare Pro 2 at home, I don't think I would recommend going out and buying a robot. That being said, when I think about what I'm going to bring to my office, what I'm going to brew regularly, I would choose the robot for these reasons. The reason is I'm brewing on a filing cabinet, so it's very, very narrow. And when you put the robot down, it is a lot more compact of a package, except for the arm swinging out a little bit, but that's not too big of a deal. I just have a very little counter space to put it on versus the robot just takes up a little bit more counter space. I think it's a little bit easier to clean the robot and I don't have to mess with preheating. The fact that I don't have to mess with preheating, it's always gonna be better if I do. That's the reason why I chose the robot for brewing in the office versus the Flare. However, it was a tough decision. I might switch that decision. I really love the Flare. I think I'm never gonna really get rid of the Flare because it's so good. It packs up so easily. I don't ever foresee myself packing up the robot and traveling. The Flare just works better. And when I think of if I were to go out and I didn't have either one of these machines, which one would I buy? I think it's an easy decision to choose the Flare, even though I prefer the robot a little better because of the fact this is travel friendly, this is still small, I can throw this in a backpack, I can take this on a plane. Some people have even brewed this while on a plane. I think that's what kind of wins on the Flare aspect side of things, and it still produces phenomenal shots. Yeah, you have a little bit of a heat issue, but it's not significant enough for me to not love this machine. Versus the robot, it doesn't come with the travel case. It works well, but for $150, I feel like one that I can travel with and one that I can use pretty much everywhere I go and save $150, I feel like it's a no-brainer to just buy this and buy hand grinder and skip the robot altogether. If you have a little bit of extra money, if you're not planning on traveling at all with it and you want the best shots possible that you can get, then the robot's your answer. That's what you're going to want to choose. That's what's going to give you the best results. But you're never going to be disappointed with the Flare, in my opinion. Both of these are going to take a lot of troubleshooting off of the bat. If you're first into espresso, they take a lot of work. There's a lot of finicking with. There's a lot of different things that you have to learn with espresso between dialing in your shots, having a good grind, having fresh beans, and a lot of other things related to that. So that's my answer. I choose the robot, but the Flare is a great contender, and I don't think the robot's worth $150. But since I have them both, thanks to your generosity through supporting this YouTube channel, I would choose to brew with the robot, and that's what I'm going to be bringing to the office next week to start brewing my coffee at work. And then I'll still probably pull this out quite a bit often at home because sometimes it's great to just have that extra sense of control while brewing coffee at home. Well, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions, please drop that in the comments below, and I would love to help you out with making the decision of the gear that you want to brew with at home. Thank you for watching.